You know that what you're doing is wrong. You know that you're pushing the boundaries and you shouldn't be, but you have no sense of consequence. So you have no real reason not to stop. You still, of course, have free will, but if you don't feel there's a reason to stop, it's easier to, you know, stay addicted and keep going further and further and further. Me and another friend contracted it at the same time, probably together. It was the consensus.
Yeah.
And we kind of hit it for a while, you know, like HIPAA laws have always been in place. And you always had this right to privacy when it came to your medical history and your medical diagnosis and health. And so it was one of those things that you could still put up this facade and keep living like you didn't, like it didn't exist. And so I noticed that with the addiction, I was able to do that. And then when my health started declining, I was able to hide it. And there's all these facades in our world that we have access to that help us hide our brokenness so we don't get help. And that's one of the really hard things that I had to learn, was to how to take down those facades to receive the help.
Mm-hmm. But at a certain point, your friends began to know that you were HIV positive. And was it sort of like the gig was up at that point, or were your friends pretty accepting?
It wasn't that big of a deal inside the community. But it was anytime dealing with things outside the community. And I had, you know, that identity was all tied into that. So it turned into, at that time, a fear to leave my comfortable place of identity to get help or, you know, go anywhere else.
So it's highly unlikely in that situation that you would leave the lifestyle. So something happened. What happened?
I started having really incredible dreams and visions. And at the time, the only thing I could call it was a download. I would just get these thoughts in my head, and I would see almost like an old Mac computer, like this information processing across the screen in real time, but it was in my mind. And it was kind of leading me and guiding me in a way that I could recognize. And these dreams and visions and these downloads were leading me to search for the faith of my youth, to search for a Bible, to maybe consider Jesus, because I come from a broken childhood. And, you know, we were Christians and we went to church, and it didn't seem to make things rosy, you know? Yeah. And so I figured, as an adult, had it worked or had it been real, things would have been different for me as a child. So I wasn't really willing to search it out again. But that's when I searched for everything else. And the more I searched, the more these desires to look for the Bible and to seek Jesus and to stop this lifestyle and to leave the drugs behind increased.
Okay. So it's not like you came from a perfect Christian family, and yet the reality of the presence of Jesus was deposited into your life. And therefore you were able to come back to it. So would you say that now that you're following the Lord, and I know you well enough to say you're following the Lord completely, full throttle, but the best you can, would you say that your life is rosy now? Or is that the wrong way to put it? Okay.
It's actually got harder since I became a Christian in ways, but I've got stronger and I've grown in character, and I've learned to trust the Lord through my challenges. So it completely changed my perspective. Whereas before, I would always be afraid of challenges and I would pray against them. And now I've embraced them. I rejoice through them. I celebrate through them. And I actually encourage, like, game on, devil. Let's bring them on, because I know I'm going to get stronger on the other side.
Yeah. And thus bringing dozens and dozens of people to help them get their demons detached from them with crazy people like me. So would you say that, like, the people that you were close to 10 years ago, and they were to talk to you now, would they say that you've changed a lot, or are you still the same Jade, but you're just into something different?
I've lost all my friends from 10 years ago, except for a couple. And they're all so supportive. They're not believers, but they're over the last 4 years, they're growing in their belief, and they've seen what God has done through me or for me over and over and over. And they're starting to really, you know, wake up. And I'm starting to see a lot of people from my past from my old lifestyle start proclaiming Jesus on Facebook. And it's so encouraging because these are people who are like me, who would have never confessed Jesus or never become a Christian just because we were so marginalized by the church for so long that it wasn't appealing to us.
Which to me, that sounds like almost like a proof of the legitimacy of it, because it would make no sense for a gay person to come to Jesus or to return to Jesus because of it's not a socially comfortable thing to do. Well, that's amazing. So either you're seeing them, some of them impacted through your life, and some of them they're just on their own with the Lord. So are these people, do you have any sense of if they're getting involved in churches, or do they just, like, what is their community? Because we're called a community, right? The gathering of believers. So what does it look like for a person who has been gay or is transitioning out of the lifestyle? Or are some of your friends still in the lifestyle, but they're kind of trying to do both?
Yeah. And I'm praying that they don't seek gay-friendly churches, only because I've experienced when I was really struggling with things, I went to a church in my community, and it was a gay-friendly church, and they were never there. They were always out at the bars, meeting people where they're at, I'm sure, but they were participating with their brokenness.
Okay, so they hadn't been set free. But
They hadn't been set free.
They were welcoming and affirming, but they didn't have a freedom to give away. And so for you, that would have still been toxic if you were drinking with them or still sexually involved with each other. So like the lifestyle is okay. Just God says it's okay. So what's with, is God just like really rigid and legalistic and anti-gay that he doesn't say it's okay? Or how do you perceive that? And how do you communicate that to people that would see the Bible or Christians as just rigid, redneck, dogmatic, hateful?
Yeah. And the biggest thing is my testimony. When I left that lifestyle, I was so broken.
Are you ready, Boo? Start walking.